In the recent video, we tackled the morphology of volcanoes. In this session, we will look at the volcanic activities. Like earthquakes, volcanic eruption is a phenomenon which cannot be predicted. Ngunit, kahit hindi natin ito maiiwasan, maaari itong paghandaan. How do we prepare for such natural disaster? There are cues to know whether a volcano is dangerous or something we really have to avoid, and some which seem calm, peaceful, and seem great for a quick sightseeing and a visit. I am referring to the classification of volcanoes based on activity. What are these classification of volcanoes based on activity? Can be classified as active volcano or inactive volcano. Active volcanoes are volcanoes with a recorded geologic activity from the last 600 years or have erupted within 10,000 years, while inactive volcanoes do not have any record of eruption or even signs of geologic activity from the last 10,000 years. Of course, if you were to ask which volcano is more frightening, which one is it? That's up to you. However, there's another type of volcano that is confirmed to no longer have geologic activity or volcanic activity, as the magma inside the magma chamber already hardened and turned into a humongous rock, and that is called an extinct volcano. The following is a list of active volcanoes in the country. Why do we need to be frightened and, if possible, avoid living near a volcano? Kailangan natin tandaan ang mga bagay na binubuga ng bulkan kapag ito ay nagkakaroon ng pagsabog. Pyroclastic flow, pyroclastic surges, tephra falls, gases, lahar, and lava flow. We also have to know the consequences of volcanic eruption. That's earthquake, tsunami, wildfires, and blasts. These serve as hazards when visiting or living near a volcano, especially an active volcano. Now that you know the hazards, let's look at the types of eruption. What are the types of eruption? There are 5 types of volcanic eruption on the list. Phreatic eruption is the usual eruption we hear from the news. Phreatic eruption is also called hydrothermal eruption dahil ito ay sanhi ng pagkakaroon ng kontak ng mga nagbabagang bato sa bulkan sa deposito ng tubig na nasa paligid ng bulkan sa ilalim ng lupa. When hot rocks meet with water, they form steam, thus causing the volcano to erupt ashes along with water vapor. Phreatomagmatic, on the other hand, is characterized by magma coming in contact with underground water, which when compared to phreatic eruption, phreatomagmatic produces stronger and powerful blasts which can even take more ash and even rocks as the volcano erupts. Strombolian eruptions are periodic eruptions of lava. This eruption is characterized by a spewing fountain of lava which may be strong to weak. This also represents an impending strong volcanic eruption which will be next on the list. Vulcanian type of eruption is a strong type of explosion as this already erupts hazardous debris as high as 20 kilometers following a pyroclastic flow along its flank. Plinian eruption, on the other hand, is the most explosive type of eruption of all. Plinian eruption destroys even the crater and the flank of an erupting volcano as a part of an explosive eruption. What characterizes the strength of eruption? Viscosity of magma or lava itself plays a big part on how strong or weak the eruption is. Viscosity refers to the resistance of a material to flow, or kung gaano kalapot ang magma o lava na galing sa bulkan. There are some factors affecting the viscosity of magma or lava. What are the factors affecting the viscosity of magma? First is temperature. While the temperature of ejected magma decreases, the viscosity also decreases until such time the lava stops, hardens, and turns into rock as a process of cooling. The next one is silica, or the composition of magma. This means that the more silica or other minerals a lava has, the more viscous will be for the ejected lava. Thus, more force will be used in blasting it out of an eruption. And finally, the amount of gas, mostly from water vapor. The more water vapor the magma has, the more explosive will be the eruption. Even if lava is already slurping down the flank or the base, the lava with more water vapor or gas will be a dangerous sight to see as gases try to escape from the lava, which causes smaller lava to splurge. Since stratovolcano and cinder volcano are characterized by explosive explosions, magma contained may be of high viscosity, while shield volcano erupts less violent, which then indicates the viscosity of magma to be less compared to other types of volcano. And we reach the end of the topic. Thanks for watching. See you on the next one.